With the Event Query Language, also known as EQL, you can hunt for malicious activity based on threat intelligence in your environment. In this video, you will learn how to take threat intelligence reports and search for attacks at any analyst level within Elasticsearch. This entire dataset is available for free at eqlplayground.io, so you can start your hunt today. Let's get started. Elasticsearch employs a layered strategy for defense. Starting with the Elastic Endpoint integration within Elastic Agent, machine learning malware models are used to classify and alert on malicious files. Ransomware protection is used to prevent files from being encrypted during an attack. Once data is sent from the endpoint to the Elastic cluster, free and open detection rules evaluate and alert on attacks. These steps reduce mean time to response and protect your environment. Even with this complex layered approach and constantly developing models, sophisticated attacks can remain hard to detect automatically. This brings about the need to perform threat hunts across an environment. As part of Elastic's philosophy to arm every analyst, we put EQL queries in our posts and reports to give the community actionable threat intelligence to use. You could easily copy this block and paste it into a correlation timeline with Elasticsearch and provide actionable value, whether you have been exposed to this action or not. The example we dive into here is from our blog post providing analysis and detections on the sunburst attacks to solar winds. However, hunting with EQL is not limited to using Elastic provided reports. To illustrate this, let's look at a threat report provided by Palo Alto's Unit 42 on Sophocy, also known as APT-28. This report does an outstanding job of outlining the attack details and every step of the infection. After reading this report, a security analyst at any level can take provided details and threat hunt for intrusions. Let's start with a basic search, keying in on the provided IOCs or indicators of compromise. The first one is the domain cdnverify.net, highlighted here. From here, we can go into the correlations tab within timeline and start writing a query. Alternatively, you can practice on this exact dataset I am using by going to eqlplayground.io. The query we can use to search for this domain is network where dns.question.name:cdnverify.net. This shows it's a network event category and a DNS request was sent out to the malicious domain. As a note, EQL syntax can be further explained in this video, writing your first event correlation rule on YouTube and in the free section on training.elastic.co. Once you run this query, the event rendered will return the results showing you the infected hostname, user, timestamps for the event, process making the call, and providing the analyzer view for more details in the timeline format. Going back to the threat intelligence report, we can look for another IOC, this time in the form of a malicious bat file this malware sample drops. cdnver.bat. Pivoting back to EQL Playground, let's enter a next query based on the file event category. Here you can enter the query file where file.name, cdnver.bat, and wait for the event rendered to return results. Surrounding the string cdnver.bat with the wildcards as indicated by the asterisk and using a colon for case insensitive allows for flexible searching across the datasets. Just like the previous example, we can get details on the host names and users that are present on this file, along with timestamps for when the file was created. From the event rendered, you can go into further analysis with the analyzer view. Now let's take a look at a slightly more complex query as we jump back to the threat report. This highlighted portion states that the process run dll32.exe calls the malicious cdnver.dll with an ordinal number 1. This provides actionable information to hunt using the process.args field. Let's see it in action on the EQL playground. In this query, we will be using the process event category and querying two fields using an AND. The query process where process.name run dll32.exe and process.args cdnver.dll is looking for an event where the process name is run dll32.exe and process arguments containing cdnver.dll are surrounded by the wildcards for search flexibility. The event rendered returns the results, and from here, the view is like our previous queries in which we can get additional details and further analyze the information with the analyzer view. The last example will be slightly more complex, using sequences. Sequences in EQL allow you to match an ordered series of events. In this query, we are searching for run dll 32.exe, making network connections after being started, and filter for those connected to private IP address using the CIDR match field. This query is powerful because it matches on a behavior from the threat intelligence report, but doesn't rely on an indicator of compromise. Once the query has been validated and submitted, the event renderer returns the results in a similar format as the earlier examples. From here, you can perform further analysis by diving deeper into the data. Thanks for watching this walkthrough on hunting APTs with threat intelligence and EQL. Head over to eqlplayground.io and test out EQL, or start your 14-day free trial in Elastic Cloud to try out EQL on your own data. For more information on eqlplayground.io, this dataset, and EQL, check out the notes section. You can learn more about EQL and get help with your queries in the docs, discuss forums, or community Slack channel. If you're ready to dive deeper into Elastic Security, kick off your Elastic Security Quick Start today.